And we are back. RawStatus.com, RawStatus TV YouTube, The RawStatus IG, The RawStatus Twitter. Find us, follow us, friend us, like us, subscribe, comment, and share. Hitting you all with a quick video today regarding this new resurfacing, seeing, and bubbling up of the old LeBron James trope that he creates a toxic environment. Yeah, it kind of feels like Groundhog Day for my 1990s movie buffs. You get that one. You get that joke. But let's discuss, once again, these same old tropes. Now, I put out a video a few days ago where I was talking about how they're already reverting to the old tropes and negativity regarding LeBron James. How they're already using his high ankle sprain as a weapon against him, just like they did when he injured his groin. Don't forget, the groin injury season turned into a fictitious bad season, and the Lakers not making the playoffs was placed on the shoulders of LeBron James, despite the fact that year they had injuries to everybody: Rondo, Kuzma, Ingram, and including LeBron James. So now, once again, since LeBron has been hurt and since AD has been hurt, and since they've fallen from second in the West, they are now kicking while down. You've been hearing the toxic environment nonsense. Now, LaMarcus Aldridge has just signed with the Nets. Once again, LaMarcus Aldridge has signed with the Nets. Now, you know what I haven't heard? Is how Durant needs so much help. Because now they've got Harden, Irving, blah, blah, blah. Coincidentally, Andre Drummond is a front runner for the Lakers. But more on that later. Let's get back to the subject at hand. So you hear this: LeBron creates a toxic environment. You can't believe it's coming back up. Now, this type of seed was fictitiously and falsely planted a few years back. When whatever, Paul George, there was some trade, something, he went to the Thunder, and they started pushing this. And of course, here you're looking at a guy, Anthony Davis, that literally fought his way out of New Orleans to play with Bron. But I don't think that false narrative is even plausible. It wasn't to begin with. And it damn sure isn't now. When you look at this guy that goes around and creates a winning environment wherever he goes, creates championship rings wherever he goes, look at what the Brooklyn Nets have to do to defeat the Los Angeles Lakers. Look at what the Clippers had to do to try to compete with LeBron James. Look at what the Golden State Warriors had to do. Then when you can't beat him, then you resort to people don't like him. Once again, the character assassination is something I've told you to watch with LeBron James. They go to assassinate his character. Why? They do it at the top, at the media, which comes from their higher-ups, which comes from the CEOs and executives, which comes from the banks and the white supremacists and the churches. You think it's not that deep with LeBron James? It damn sure is. So by time it filters out to the general public, the wanting to stop this guy from becoming a billionaire tycoon who's actually interested in helping people that look like him get out of poverty. Then they create the character assassinations, and it filters down to the layman society, and through osmosis, they promote LeBron James hatred, not basketball analysis. You see this in big corporate sports media. You see it in the YouTubian atmosphere. You see it, you hear it on the radio. there's just a negative cloud of energy now that is around LeBron James. People just don't like the guy. Not because he's unlikable, because they are instructed to. The toxic environment. First of all, when Durant made those comments, he wasn't even talking about LeBron James. He was talking about the media. But don't forget, with Durant, there's always kind of been this low-key jealousy of LeBron and what his status is socially and politically and economically and what his is versus. You're just not that star, dude. But this is a false narrative, like I said. If you really look at the tail of the tape, if you really inspect what he's done and where he has been, something can either be true or false. So when we deal in true or false, we deal in science. Not in hyperbole, not in emotion, not in hatred, not in brainwashing, but the truth. That's what science is all about, right? That's what scientific experiments are all about, to get to the bottom of it, to find out the truth. So what is the truth when it comes to LeBron and the former teams that he's played? The truth, in a word, rings, winning, revenue. I guess those are three words. You can use any one of those words and make it in a word. Let's just talk about the money that the franchises, not even the players, but the franchises have made off of having LeBron on their team. In particular, the Cleveland Cavaliers. Let's talk about the players that have played with LeBron and how toxic their careers ended up after being on the court with him, like Kevin Love or J.R. Smith or Tristan Thompson or Anthony Davis or Kyle Kuzma. What about the hotels and the restaurants and the bars and lounges around the arenas in the towns where he plays? What about the fact that former players never really seem to have anything negative to say about the guy? Except for haters like Stephon Marbury or what have you. So again, when you actually spend time and break it down, which I can go even further than that, but when you break down the true or the false. But there's no need to, because you understand that where that these questions and these statements about playing with LeBron James are based in hatred. They come from a place of hate. Some of it is jealousy. Some of it is regional. Some of it is pure fandom. But most of it, again, is coming down from the top, stemming back to the decision. What the big corporate media, aka the white supremacist controlled media, calls the decision. That's when LeBron James took control of the white supremacist controlled media. And if you ask me, he should have never relinquished that control. I believe he should have thrown his own press conference and started his own sports network. He should have never done another corporate press conference again. He should have thrown his own. There may have been some contractual conflicts with his NBA contract. I don't know, but I would have liked to see that, to tell you the truth. So again, I don't have much else to say on this subject, but just remember that these narratives about LeBron, just the straight up negativity that has nothing to do with basketball, none of which are true, which are all easily proven false if you really just break down the facts, are there for a reason. And they're being promoted by people that may not understand the problem or may have some type of sports agenda, basketball agenda invested. But the underlying political nature and just the straight up and down bullshit, the falsity of an environment around LeBron James not being conducive to winning and people not wanting to play with the guy. No, it's people want to play on a team where they can, where the team can have five all-stars and they can all beat the guy because they can't do it alone. Let's just tell the truth. We all saw what happened to James Harden in the playoffs last year. But leave your comments in the box. This is Raw Status.